Super Chemist Project 86. My millennium skills are taking over like computers, leaving large blisters on the tongues of my intruders. When they try to follow the pattern, capture the plutonic audience that I leave upon an audience. My writings are dangerous, contagious like pink eye. You come too close and you will be contaminated. Clonites hate it, the government is concerned, so they put Scully and Mulder on the case. But I move very quickly and I'm very hard to trace. Plus, like Mr. Wilson, no one's really seen my face. I live by grace, ushering in ecclesiastical outpourings, one that this world has never seen before. I have no title, but still they try. But every time they get close, like a maggot, I fly south over the sea, watching for the beast called blasphemy. Allowed to have authority and all earthly powers at his command. Upon him I stare as he comes out of the water with feet shaped like a bear. As he touches dry soil, my emotions begin to boil. I lick a shot at one of his seven heads with intentions of spoil. But he just continues on his journey, not even concerned with me. Stops at the equator and heals his wound, then pulls another beast from the tomb. Like a lamb seen in the natural realm as a normal man, possessing the same powers he economically devours, doing great miracles, sucking in doubters. He tells all homo sapiens the first beast is greater, be destroyed or worship your savior. He's now established himself as the man, telling presidents to unite the world by putting a mark on everyone's right hand. The world's not rebelling because the stage is set tight, flood the world with violence, so everybody thinks it's all right to take the mark of the beast, which is looked upon as a symbol of peace. And it is a piece. A piece of your soul is what I scream as I stand right in front of you, but you ain't even hearing a thing.
Why you saving me? What's happening to me? What's happening to me?